Well, good morning, church. It's so good to be with you all. Would you stand up with us? We're going to worship our Savior this morning. Let's put our hands together as we sing about His grace that He so freely gives us.
Lord, how You love me, I don't deserve grace on top of grace.
Today we get to celebrate that freedom that we have in Jesus. Let's put our hands together. Ooh, yeah. Oh, Jesus.
Out of the shadows, step out of the grave. Break into the wild and don't be afraid.
We sing, run into what?
Run into wide open spaces, graces waiting for you. A dance like the weight has been lifted, graces waiting.
Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom, there is freedom. Yes, it is. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom, there. as we celebrate that freedom that He so freely gives to us.
Bring all of your burdens, bring all of your scars.
Come back to communion, come back to the start.
Run into wide open spaces, grace is waiting for you. Prison shake at the sound of Jesus' name.
Sing, life's made whole.
Life's made whole. Hearts awake at the sound of Jesus' name.
Chains will fall. Prison shake at the sound of Jesus' name.
Amen. Oh, it's a good, good day to be here. Amen? Amen. Okay, so check this out. 68 years ago in 1954, there was an announcer at Oxford University, and he made the announcement. He was doing the announcements for the 1 mile run, okay? And as they were announcing the winner of the 1 mile run for the first time ever, instead of announcing it that the winner had won at 4 minutes, he used the word three. And he didn't even have to go any farther than to say three, and the crowd went nuts because they knew that for the first time ever, somebody had broken the 4 minute mark for running a mile, which was considered the standard in athletic achievement, especially for running and track and athletics. And so for the first time ever, Roger Bannister ran a mile, and he ran it in 3 minutes, 59.4 seconds. Okay, so now that's impressive. But 2 months later, two other people ran a mile in under 4 minutes and beat his time too. So then here's the question I have for you. Is that the year they had invented Gatorade and Under Armour? Like, why is it that all of a sudden this thing that they had waited hundreds of years to do, they finally did for the first time ever? We're not going to be sure, but I suspect it has something to do with the fact that for the first time ever, other people saw somebody do it and they realized that it was possible. As if to say they were given permission. For today, you're going to see people come out here and be baptized. That they have stepped away from a life of sin and death, and that they will live a life new because of their faith in Jesus. We do this for a few reasons. This is a marker of our Christian faith. And we do this for a few reasons. The first is that we as human beings, we tend to be a bit forgetful. We forget things. God went so far as to use piles of rocks to remind his people of what he has done. And so there will be days for these people who are baptized in the future, as scripture says, that the heart is deceitful. There'll be days that they don't feel saved. And yet what we know is that we mark this moment to acknowledge what God is doing in their life and will continue to do. It is a public declaration of what God is doing on the inside. So that's the first. The second is this. We get a chance as a community to support this. The Christian life was never designed to be alone. We were never intended to do this by ourselves. We are intended to do this together. So then what that means is that we are a part of a celebration. We are a part of life change. And we now have the opportunity to step into life with these people so that we support them, we pray for them, we hold them accountable because they too were never intended to do this life alone. And so we join in this together. We're active participants in life change. Amen? So then, I give you permission, though you don't need it, and I have no authority to give it to you, but I give you permission to celebrate. I give you permission to lean in. That's what this entire day is designed to do and to be. It is designed to celebrate these people that have made that life change and that we get to be a part of that. And we've taken an entire hour. I was talking to one of our volunteers. This feels extravagant and luxurious. And yet I go, that's life change. Shouldn't that be the most extravagant thing that we do? Yeah, and so today is extravagant. We will spend our time watching life change, hearing stories, seeing people being baptized, and then we get the chance through worship, through prayer, through song, to respond. What a good day it is. And so again, I give you permission. So a couple things. If you have already signed up to be baptized, we would invite you to head out the back doors and we'll walk you over to where you're gonna be getting ready. Here's the other thing I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna come back out here at some point and I'm gonna invite anybody else. If God is moving in your life and you feel like today is the day, head out into the lobby and talk to one of our counselors. We would love for this to be your marked moment as well. So allow me to, as we continue on in worship, I'm gonna read for us one of the Psalms that declares not only what we get to do, who we are, and why we get to do it. Psalm 66, 1-8 says, "Shout for joy to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of his name, make his praise glorious. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds, so great is your power that your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bows down to you, they sing praise to you, they sing the praises of your name. Come and see come and see what God has done, his awesome deeds for mankind. Praise our God, all peoples. Let the sound of his praises be heard. So that's our job today. Let the sound of our praises not be confined by these walls and the internet and wherever you're joining us. This roof will not hold our praise. It goes beyond that. So that's what we do today. Amen.
As Pastor Jeff just said, I invite you guys to lean in. We're gonna worship this morning. If you wanna sit, if you wanna move to a corner in the room, if you wanna get on your knees, if you feel comfortable to lift your hands, I invite you to join us as we declare who our Savior is. You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. Let's sing that again. to you this morning? Is he your promise keeper, your light in the darkness?
Way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
We sing, even when I don't feel it, you're working.
Even when I don't feel it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working.
You never stop working.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working.
Oh, you never stop working.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. came here with nothing, but all you have given me, Jesus, bring new wine out of me. Yes, you are so good. In the crushing, in the crushing, in the pressing, you are making new wine. In the soil I, in the soil I now surrender, you are breaking new ground. You are breaking, you are breaking.
We're so-
The atmosphere is changing now, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here. Let's sing that this morning. The atmosphere. The atmosphere is changing now here in this place, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. Oh, yes, it is. The evidence is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here. We sing overflow.
Overflow. Fill our hearts with your love, your love.
With us. You can have a seat.
Hi, my name's Rochelle, and I'm here to get baptized. And the reason I want to get baptized is because there was a time in my life where I did not feel worthy or wouldn't be accepted in a church. And from, you know, past relationships. And now I know that God was working in my life even when he was protecting me in those relationships and got me through those times. And now I feel worthy and I want to give my life to the Lord. And I'm just so grateful.
Hi, my name is Grace. I'm getting baptized because I was lost in the New Age lifestyle for probably 12 years. There was a lot of demonic undertones within the New Age, and I was able to see that, and I want nothing to do with that. And I've been seeking truth and the truth in God, so I'm here for God.
Hi, my name is Anthony Molina. I'm getting baptized because I would like to cleanse my soul and begin my walk with the Lord. Before attending Northgate Church, I was lost and confused and had no direction in life. And once I stepped through these doors, I realized to become a better man, I needed to surrender to the Lord to be a righteous man in Christ.
Hi, my name is Gisela Molina, and I want to get baptized so I could give my life to God and draw closer to Him. Ever since I started attending youth group, I got more connected with God, and I want to serve Him with my whole heart.
Hey guys, my name is Justin Edwards, and today I'm getting baptized. I feel like for like the longest time, I have kind of been planted in like the wrong ground, and God calls us to plant our lives on a firm foundation. And today on my shirt, I wrote the word found. There's a Bible verse that really speaks to me, Psalm chapter 139, verses 7 to 13. And it says, "Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness will hide me and your light become night around me, even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day, for darkness is as light to you." You see, I feel like I ran away from God for such a long time, and I feel like I was lost, but now I'm found.
Picture of your faithfulness. I'm a miracle in process. God, I never would have guessed that you were working in the darkness. Camera. ashes, you make beautiful things. I know, 'cause you did it in me. From the ashes, from the ashes, you make beautiful things. It's so good, Jesus. I know, 'cause you did it in me.
And here's the best part. We're not done yet. No, you can even stay standing because we're going to continue to worship. We're going to continue. But here's the call that I get to make. The water's warm. We got plenty of t-shirts and towels back there. I think there's still a little bit left in the cowbells, right? Can I hear them? Can I? Okay, good, good. I was just afraid there was no more cowbell. So good, good. So then with that, is there anyone else who wants to be baptized? Because it's Jesus made it possible. He made it possible. He tore the veil. We now are in relationship with God because of what Jesus did. We celebrate that new life. So here's the deal. We're going to continue to worship. We're going to continue to lean in. We're going to continue to celebrate the life change and the stories that you've heard. But there's space. So if you'd like to, we invite you to head out that exit right there. There are counselors who want to pray with you, who want to get you a t-shirt, want to get you a towel, and we'd love to celebrate what God is doing in your life right now, today. Amen? Amen. So join me, stand up. We're going to continue to worship, and we'll see you in a bit.
This next song as a blessing over each of you individually, over your families, over your children. It says, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you and may it give you rest. If you know it, sing it with us. Forever, Jesus. So we say, may his favor be upon you. May his favor be upon you in a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you in a thousand generations, and your family, your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you in a thousand generations, and your family, your children, and their children, and their children. May his presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. With you, you see it. He's with you in the morning, in the for you, and behind. know that you are for us. You are not against us. So as we sing this next song, we're going to declare, Lord, send me. We're going to say, here I am. Even in my brokenness, in my joy, that you would use me, Jesus.
If it's bandaging the broken, washing filthy feet, here I am, Lord, send me. If it's loving one another, even when we don't agree, we say, here I am, 'cause here I am, Lord, send me.
here I am. 'Cause here I am, Lord, send me. Oh, here I am, here I am, Lord, send me. Keep going with the here I am. 'Cause here I am.
You have no rival.
God is good, amen? Oh, let's give him one more praise. Absolutely. What a good day. What a good day. Hey, friends, if there's anything that we can do for you, if you've put your faith in Jesus today, or if you've got questions about your faith, we've got our This Changes Everything corner over there. We'd love to get a chance to meet you, pray with you. We've got a little book for you that we'd love to give to you. Or if you're joining us online, you can text us at TCE1 at 94,000. You can do that. And then if you're new, and you have questions about our church or what? Why do we have cowbells? What in the world is this? You guys are a bunch of partiers. We've got our new friends corner, and we'd love to meet with you. We've got a little gift for you, our Matthew journal that we're going to be going through and jumping back into next week. And then if you, as a follower of Jesus, or if you want to just get equipped in your faith, we've got Northgate U, and that is launching this week. That's happening. And so if you have any questions, that's out in the lobby, and we can give you information for that. But for now, I would love to invite you. I'd love to pray for us and to say a blessing over us. And as we go out and live in the new life that Jesus invites us to. And one of the ways that we invite you to do that is to put out your hands as a sign of receiving. I find that for myself, that when I do something with my body, my head and my heart follow suit. And so friends, may we now live in the new life of what Jesus offers. That it's because of Jesus that we celebrate. It's because of Jesus that we worship. And it's because of Jesus that we have new life. In his name we pray. Amen. Have a great week. We'll see you soon. God bless you guys.